you for checking out my channel. Thank you for clicking on this video. This video is part of the series of videos I post to try to help people out when it comes to aptitude tests, like the civil service exam, UPCAT, LAE, PhilSat, and all of those things. Today, we're going to talk about another math lesson. Actually, na-discuss na natin before yung GCF, saka LCM, some of the techniques that I use, but I haven't discussed the ladder method yet, and that's what we're going to do today. Now, if you want to catch all of the videos I make at least one new video lesson every week, you can go ahead and click subscribe and hit the bell icon para hindi yun ma-miss. And I'm going to switch over to my PC right now so I can show you how to do it. I'll see you in a bit. Alright, so let's talk about ladder method. GCF and LCM tayo. I'm just going to demonstrate to you yung concept ng ladder method. Okay, I know a lot of you already know this, pero let's cover this in case na you've already forgotten. Now, the beauty about this technique is whether you're looking for GCF and LCM, you're going to use the same method. May onting difference lang doon sa execution. Okay, let's talk about it. So we have a number pair right here, 80 and 104. Hinahanap yung GCF or greatest common factor and LCM or least common multiple nilang dalawa. How do you deal with this and how do you find the answer? Now, using the ladder technique, ang gagawin lang natin is basically if a factor natin sila hanggang ma-reduce natin sila dun sa lowest nila na itsura or lowest na form. So lahat ng pwedeng factor nilang dalawa ililista natin. So let's start with 2. Ang 2 kasi madali kasi even sila pareho. Now, if you don't know the technique kung paano malalaman whether a number or a number pair is pwedeng i-divide sa isang number or paano mahanap yung mga factors ng isang number, I already made a series on that, yung factoring na series natin, yung quick technique. Click na lang dito sa bandang taas dun sa I para ma-access ninyo yung video na yun. Kasi yun yung pinaka-fundamentals or yung tools na ginagamit natin dito sa ganito para hindi naman kailangan try kayo ng try mula sa 1, ta-try, 2, tapos 3, paulit-ulit. Okay, so at first glance, hopefully makikita nyo. Now, since both of them are even numbers, you know that you can divide them by 2. So, ang ladder method, magdodrawing ka ng ganyan, okay, that is one wrong, and then you put 2. Ang 2 is the factor, okay, again, kasi pwede mo silang i-divide pareho sa 2. The next step would be, i-divide mo ngayon sila talaga sa 2. So, 80 divided by 2 would be 40, and then 104 divided by 2 would be 50. Again, anong ginawa ko? Di-divide ko lang sila doon sa factor na nilagay ko dito. Okay? Now, since both of them are still even numbers, pwede ko uli silang gawin. I-divide ko uli sila sa 2. So again, I'll add another rung ng ladder and then I'll put 2 here, which is again, factor nilang dalawa. And then I'm going to repeat the process. So 40 divided by 2 would be 20. 52 divided by 2 is 26. Now, same thing again, pwede pa rin sa 2 kasi pareho pa rin silang pwedeng i-divide sa 2. So, I'll put another rung, another 2 right there. Di-divide ko ulit. 20 divided by 2 is 10. 26 divided by 2 is 13. Now, pagdating ko dito, wala na silang common factor. Okay? Wala na akong number na pwedeng i-divide dito na pwede ko rin i-divide dito. Kasi 2, hindi na pwede kasi hindi na to even. 3, hindi naman din sila pareho divisible sa 3. Again, dito papasok yung recognition ninyo ng factors, no? And since wala na akong pwedeng i-divide sa kanila na parehong number, the process ends there. Yung ladder method ends there. Now, if you're looking for the GCF, what you're going to do actually is just deal with everything na nasa left side. Yung 2, 2 at 2, 2 times 2 times 2, imumultiply ko lang yung nandito sa left side. Okay? So, 2 times 2 is 4 times 2. That would give you 8. Ang greatest common factor nila would be 8. Now, kapag ang hinahanap ay LCM, again, we're not changing the ladder. All we're going to do is, instead of dito lang tayo sa side na to titingin, titingnan natin yung buong pa L. Okay? So, in order for you to remember better, tandaan nyo lang L. Kasi L-shape yung ating i-multiply. So, we're starting with 2 times 2 times 2. This is 8 times 10, that is 80, times 13. So, 80 times 13. And we're just going to solve this. Okay? So, again, you can do a number of methods dito, pwede mong gawing i-long cut ninyong ganyan, or what I usually do is just I put 13 times 8 na lang, yun na lang iniisip ko, so I put 130, that is times 10, tapos babawasan ko lang siya ng dalawa, so that would be 26. Okay, so this is 104, tapos lalagyan ko lang ng isang 0 pa, kasi 80 yung minultiply ko, hindi naman 8. So, my LCM would be 1,040. Again, GCF, itong side lang na to, isang nakatayo lang. Pag LCM, lahat na sila i-multiply mo to get to the answer. Okay?
Now, bakit ko dinidiscuss ito? Kasi hopefully, makatulong sa inyo sa exam, malalaman ninyo kung ano yung gagawin ninyo. Again, you can use yung factor 3, you can use this, whatever works for you for certain problems, you're going to use that. Ang sa akin lang kasi, I use the factor 3 primarily kapag ang pinatanong ay radicals, and then when it comes to straightforward na ganito, I use this or the other technique that I taught in my other LCM or LCD video, yung minultiply ko na lang sa 2. Okay, kasi ito sa akin, it's very tedious, lalo na kung marami yung numbers. Pero helpful din naman kung na-master nyo siya. Okay, so again, ang goal ko here is not for you to follow everything I teach. Kung makakatulong sa inyo yung iba or ibang style, you can do that as long as makapasa kayo ng exam. That is my primary goal. Okay?
Alright, I hope you learned something new today. If you did, click thumbs up. Make sure to share this video with your friends lalo na kung mag-exam din sila para mas marami tayong matulungan. And as always, if you want to reach out to me directly, you can go to www.facebook.com/teamlyqa to find out how to get the reviewers that I made or join one of the review events that I'm going to teach at next. So thank you guys, and as always, don't forget to hit subscribe if hindi pa kayo nakasubscribe, and hit the bell icon para hindi niyo mamiss yung susunod na lesson. I'm trying to make as much of these videos as possible para makaabot pa sa inyong pag-exam. So thank you guys, and never stop learning. Adyo kayo niyan. I'll see you in my next video, and bye for now.